Well, Florida residents are hunkering down tonight as Hurricane Helene makes landfall.
The storm expected to bring catastrophic damage for parts of Florida's Big Bend area. ABC 3340's Megan Scarano is live in Panama City Beach for us tonight. Megan, you're west of landfall. What are you seeing tonight?
Well, tonight we're finally seeing a little bit of break in the rain here. All day long, it was kind of this constant light rain. It hasn't really poured down here yet. Really, the wind, Brenda, is more noticeable than anything.
And Megan, you were all along the beach earlier. What made you decide to move inland?
Really, when it was just pouring down, not pouring down, but really it was just coming down. When you're out in the elements, there's no really anywhere to hide when you're out there at the beach. So because of that strong wind coming off the waves and the water moving up onto the shore, we knew it was just going to keep continuing to coming in, especially with the high tide. We would just wanted to make sure we were safe for our couple of live shots that we were having here tonight. So we decided to we're just really outside of the hotel underneath an awning to protect us for any of the potential elements that we could really see.
Okay, so earlier I know that there were people in the water as well. Did you notice people were clearing out maybe when the sun went down?
I will say that we left before people left. So there were still people on the beach taking videos, taking pictures, coming out to see what it looked like, and there was still a surfer in the water when we were leaving. So I can't really say when people left there tonight, but we were out there until about 6:30, and there were still plenty of people walking up and down the shore and a surfer in the water.
All right, Megan Scarano, thank you for your reporting tonight, reporting live from Panama City. And as Hurricane Helene makes landfall, Alabama parks are welcoming evacuees. It's not the first time Alabama parks have opened their gates to those looking to escape a natural disaster. The Alabama State Parks website has even been updated to make finding the nearest park and availability as easy as possible. All 21 Alabama state parks are preparing for additional visitors, including Oak Mountain State Park.
The storm impacted areas, or the ones that we anticipate receiving storm impact, there are quick paths to all our parks. And so really, I think I can't stress enough that it's so important for people to go to alapark.com, click that yellow button, the map is right there, and you can literally say, I'm here, I wanna be here.
If you or someone you know is looking to get out of the path of Helene, you can find more information and a link to lodging accommodations on our website, abc3340.com.
Well, crews from across the state are prepared to step in and help where needed. FEMA workers prepared for Hurricane Helene today at Maxwell Air Force Base in Montgomery.
Oh, it's fascinating to watch the landfall of these intense hurricanes with radar. So here we go. This is the coast right here, and you can see the eye is right on top of the coast, so landfall has occurred. Perry, Florida is right here, and they've been taking the northern eye wall. They'll touch the southern eye wall in about 15 minutes. But again, we have wind velocities here of about 140 miles per hour. This will create major widespread damage. Tallahassee is here, and the polygon you see here, this purple polygon, that is an extreme wind warning. You don't see those that often, but this thing is really accelerating north. This will likely be northeast of Atlanta early tomorrow morning. We'll check the satellite perspective, and again, there's the eye coming on shore tonight. This will come on shore as a Category 4. Top winds 140 miles per hour. And of course, the storm surge is tremendous along and to the right of the circulation center. And again, we stress the good side over here. That would include Panama City Beach and Points West. No trouble there at all. And again, really over to Indian Pass, Cape San Blas, and Port St. Joe. They're on the offshore flow side, which is the good side. So again, the Category 4 hurricane right on shore tonight, accelerating rapidly. And again, by tomorrow morning, the system should be a tropical storm northeast of Atlanta. The big problems overnight will not be here. We're on the good side. Over here in Georgia, the Carolinas, the southern Appalachians, they could see a lot of wind, a lot of rain, power outages, the chance of isolated tornadoes, but we expect nothing like that in our state. The remnant circulation gradually dissipating up north.
by Saturday. So here's the radar tonight. Rain is relatively widespread for the eastern third of the state, and that's where the bulk of the rain will be. There's a flash flood warning in effect now for parts of Lee and northern Russell counties. That includes Auburn and Opelika. For the Birmingham metro, just some light rain. And again, the rain should be very light for the Interstate 65 corridor, heaviest rain near the Georgia line. There's the big perspective, but again, soaking rains in Georgia and a few tornado warnings over here from time to time, those red polygons you see. So rain amounts near the Georgia line could exceed 2 inches. The Birmingham metro, just not that much. And again, parts of West Alabama getting absolutely no rain at all. In terms of wind overnight, for most of the state, winds gusting to 20, 25 miles an hour. But near the Georgia state line, we could see a few wind gusts there up to about 40 miles an hour. That's tropical storm strength. But again, the bulk of the wind and the rain will be over here in the state of Georgia overnight as the system moves on in. And tomorrow will be a fairly windy day. What happens, the circulation hooks back over to Tennessee as it dissipates, merging with an upper low, and that pattern will likely create wind gusts tomorrow afternoon, maybe up to 30, 35 miles an hour. And then after that, things look pretty good for the weekend. We'll be mostly dry Saturday and Sunday. Cloudy and breezy, rain for East Alabama tonight, lows between 61 and 65. Tomorrow, a windy day, a mix of sun and clouds, a few scattered afternoon and evening showers, especially north of Birmingham, the high 74. A slight chance of a shower Saturday, then we're dry Sunday through all of next week with highs back in the low 80s. Catch my forecast tomorrow morning with the Rick and Bubba Show on Birmingham's 104.7 WZZK.